It's getting so hot, so hot.
You're watching Tools for Talent on TFT TV. I'm your host, Cheryl Martinez, and I'm very excited to introduce my special guest today, model Savannah Vinson.
Hi, how are you?
I'm great.
Thank
how are you,
so
sweetheart?
Much. Thank you. Trying to stay warm with this weather, for sure.
Oh, yes. It is the coldest day we had. In fact, yesterday, I kid you not, I was walking only two blocks, and I was scared for my life. Short girl problems, for real. The wind literally almost blew me away into the middle of traffic. I was, like, running with the winds, and I couldn't even keep my feet. It was scary out
there. I've had that happen, where the umbrella flips completely opposite, and you're trying to, like, hold on.
Well, that wasn't the umbrella. They were just picking me up. It was picking me up in the air.
Yeah, it's crazy.
But yeah, thank you so much for being here.
Yeah,
it's an honor to have you on the show.
Yeah, I'm excited.
So we have a lot of things to talk about today. I know that you are fairly new to the Tools for Talent company, but we are very excited to have you not only on the show, but on our talent roster.
Yes, for sure.
So you are actually one of our youngest models on our roster. I know you're kind of representing the teen division for us. So I kind of wanted to focus your interview kind of inspiring the younger generation of models of what it's like to get bookings in their teenage years, because I know a lot of people, you know, don't really get to start their modeling careers till after college
older,
because,
yeah,
you know, they want to have the degree to fall back on and stuff like that. So I wanted to kind of figure out how it all happens for you and how you were able to get some of the amazing bookings that we're about to touch on at such a young age.
Yeah, of course. So I'm originally from Ohio, so when I first started, before modeling, I was in pageants, so I was big into that.
Oh.
And when I first actually started modeling, I signed with an agency called New View, and I actually fell into a scam, paid like $2,000. It was insane, yeah, but they did teach me, like, how to apply makeup, but I already knew that previous.
Hold on. I'm sorry, but everyone knows the show is called Tools for Talent. We provide tools, tips, and advice for aspiring talent, and one of the main things we focus on, which I'm very glad you brought up, are exposing scams.
Yes.
So, would you mind sharing that scam story real quick?
Yeah, of course.
About, you don't have to get full into it, but just basically,
little
you
idea
know,
about it.
And also what you learned from it, like, i.e., like, what were the red flags that you now notice now that you might not have noticed then.
Any agency that's at a mall and hands you a brochure saying, like, you're gonna be a star, come on down, like, we want you to be a part of this agency. So, you know, I came on
at
down.
At the mall? Red flag number one.
Okay, so anyways, I go to this place, beautiful studio, you know, and they have pictures of all their success stories. And we did a little interview, and they're like, we love your look, we're gonna teach you how to apply the makeup, and after that, you'll be able to go to bookings. Great, so they're like, just pay $2,000 and we'll go from there. So, of course, I was like, this is my dream, this is what I want to do, so I paid that money, and then nothing came from it. Nothing.
So I'm sure you tried to follow up with them, though, to get your money back, and so what happened there?
Yeah, so I tried to keep on getting jobs with them, and actually, when I would book work myself, they'd be like, we need a percentage of this.
Did you sign an exclusive contract with them?
It was. I know,
And again, how old were you at that time?
I was, officially, when I started, I was 15.
So did you show that contract to your parents or
maybe so my family was there the whole time. They went through it. We had tons of people there with us who went through the same experience. But afterwards, we're like, we learned from it. We're done with it.
I guess my question was, what made you think it was okay to sign? Who told you, sure, sign this exclusive contract?
Well, like I said, at the time, like, everything they were saying was good. Like, you wanted to hear it, especially when you're getting into the agency. It's super exciting. So, and then your family, when they hear that, they don't know anything about it as well. So they're like, oh, this sounds great. There's all these success stories over here. Like, let's do it.
Okay.
So
that's something that actually scares me a lot in this industry, is a lot of people use hope. And hope blinds them from actually just being able to trust their own instincts, because they're so hopeful and they're so excited and they're being fed all these things that could happen, that they kind of lose sight on, like, what their instincts are actually telling them. So you are probably not thinking about, oh, you know, is it really such a smart idea to sign exclusive contracts, because they're promising you the world. So you're like, well, if I'm gonna XYZ, sure, I'll sign whatever you say. But especially at a young age, you really, really, really need to take your time, work non-exclusively with several agencies, see which ones are getting you really great work, and then you make the decision
if you wanna
on if there's one of them brand that keeps giving you consistent work and is really putting you at like their top of their roster and going out of their way working for you, mm-hmm. then you can consider an exclusive relationship with them.
Yeah, I totally agree.
But so many models work non-exclusively for so many years, and I really don't recommend exclusivity, just, you know, for the viewers mm-hmm. watching the show, unless you've been with them already on a long-term basis, non-exclusive.
I agree, because once it is non-exclusive, your picture, your comp card will get up there with a million other girls that are with the agency.
Yeah.
So you want something that's non-exclusive, you're able to do things freely mm-hmm. and book your own work.
And with social media nowadays, girls can be their own agent in a way, where they're getting, girls and guys are getting their own offers. Just being themselves on their own without needing an agent manager. So if you have an exclusive contract, now any of those offers you get on your own, you'll be required to pay a percentage of that mm-hmm. If you're signed exclusively. So that's another thing to think about, because mm-hmm. if you're, you know, with us in this current day and age about getting your own gigs on through social media marketing, you know, you need to be aware that that's something that you're also going to be giving a cut from if you're in exclusive contracts.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So yeah, I definitely learned from that lesson.
Yeah.
So then I actually graduated high school a year early and moved here in August. Mm-hmm. And since moving here, I went to a couple different agencies and found out which ones are the right ones, and I signed with them. Mm-hmm. And then pretty much I've been doing my own thing since then, and yeah. I love it.
Awesome. So how'd you find out about Tools for Talent Company, huh?
Oh my gosh, good question. I believe, was there a casting?
I don't remember. I thought maybe you would remember.
I know. I want to say there was a casting, and I applied to it, and I was like, hey, like, this is my resume.
Yeah.
Here's some pictures, mm-hmm. and I would love to be a part of it, because definitely love what the meaning is behind it.
Thank you. Well, I mean, we get submissions all the time, and obviously this girl stood out to me. Otherwise, she would not be here right now. One of the most exciting things she has coming up is a billboard in New York City. Why don't you just get everyone excited for this real quick?
Yes, I'm so excited. So, since I was a little girl, this has been a dream of mine to see myself walking in New York City, just being like, oh my God, like, that's my freaking face.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's for Zumba, so I'll be in a workout. Running, looking.
I love Zumba, by the way. I have the Xbox Zumba DVD.
It's a good workout.
I do my own little, like, workout.
It'll get you sweating.
Yeah.
So it'll be in the Village somewhere. So everyone, keep an eye out for it. I'm really excited.
Nice. What's the pose?
It's like me running, dancing.
All right, got it. You guys got it? All right, we're going to look out for you. If anyone sees it, make sure you that you tag her mm-hmm. In your stories. Take a little story of it. What's your Instagram?
Yeah, so my Instagram name is @queen.sav_.
Okay, and how long is it going to be up for? Did they tell you?
They did not tell me, so.
And it's starting when?
I want to say, like, in a month or so.
Okay.
So it's close.
Nice.
But when they tell me officially when it's out, then I'm going to be like, all right.
So about when this airs is probably the same time the billboard
comes.
Should be up.
Which, yeah, I'm so excited.
Great. All right. So why don't we talk a little bit about the road from, you know, moving to New York to getting on this billboard.
Mm-hmm.
So what is that path right there?
Okay. So finding an apartment was hell, especially in New York City.
Yes, New York City is known for that.
Oh my gosh. So after I found it, pretty much constantly, I was just going to agencies, just seeing, like, which one was the right one for me, because I didn't want to get screwed over again, obviously.
Yeah.
So after that, I got signed, and then once I was signed, I was like, all right.
Non-exclusive.
Yes, for sure. And after that, I started getting stuff on my own, because networking is everything nowadays. Like, Instagram, it's free. Everyone goes to it. And it's all about how many followers you have.
I pay for Instagram. It's free.
What? No, but yeah. So people forget to use that as an advantage.
Mm-hmm.
So constantly networking, handing out my business cards. You never know who you're sitting by on the subway.
Sure.
So constantly doing that and building my way up. That's pretty much how I got here. And I'm going to keep on working on more and more and bigger clientele, so.
It's funny you say business cards, though, because I feel like business cards are becoming a little bit obsolete little by little over time. Instead of people handing out their business cards, oh, let me hand you my Instagram username, you know, is kind of what it's turning into,
I totally agree,
you know,
but
good and bad, but, you know.
It's good, though, because, like, if I'm on a rush to a casting or something, and they're like, oh, like, I love your look, I'll just be like, hey, like, sorry, I gotta go, and then they can contact you, and...
For me, it's like, oh, when someone, like, sees me on the street, or it's, like, a guy trying to get my number or something, and I don't want to be rude, I feel like, oh, I can't give you my number, sorry, but you can have my Instagram.
Follow me, raise some follows,
I'll give you my Instagram, no problem.
No, that's so funny, though.
Yeah. Okay, so now, would you say, what percentage of your bookings are from agencies, and what percentage is from on your own?
Honestly, I would say about 80% of my bookings is through myself.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. See, and that's something to, like, to be aware of, you mm-hmm. know, like, for those of you guys watching, if you can get 80% of your bookings on your own, do you really want to be paying an exclusive, you know,
no, like I said, you'll just be put up on that board
exclusivity in order to give them 10 to 20% of 80% of the work that you mm-hmm. get on, you know, like, so it's just something to
and
think
like
about.
The models who are with the exclusive contracts
mm-hmm. they complain to you,
they yes for sure, but the people who are actually getting like a lot of work, it's because they know someone of someone, like I said, it's all okay. about connections, it's yeah. not
yeah
you know.
So what would you say has been, besides that first scam starting out, which I have to say, even though that was a bad experience, I think you were lucky that it happens in the beginning.
Mm-hmm, so I could
because,
learn from it.
Yeah, because now you kind of had, you know, you got that out of the way. Mm-hmm. So now you were ready to go instead of it, you know, happening like maybe a little in there or when you're already deep in, you know, you weren't that deep in.
Yeah.
That. Like $2,000 is not that bad. I know that there are scams that are much, much bigger
oh, yeah.
and much, much worse. In fact, we even have some, part of something else we do on TFT TV is we do comedy skits acting out existing scams. So we have some, if you guys go to youtube.com/toolsfortalent, you can check out some of our comedy/parody scam exposed stories. It's they're pretty hilarious.
So. Oh, yeah. I want to watch that after this.
Yeah, and, you know, and the point is to educate, though, right?
Yeah.
You know, yes, we want to entertain you, but we also want to educate you. That's
yeah,
because
it's something serious, and people are really messed up who actually...
Yeah. Yeah.
Who actually think it's okay yeah. to do this.
So if you guys have any scam stories, send it to tv@toolsfortalent.com, and maybe we will turn your scam story into a skit to help mm-hmm. educate and build awareness for something that you suffered through, so we can turn that into mm-hmm. a positive. Okay, so I also want to talk about your acting and dancing career. Why don't you enlighten us a little bit on what's going on
yeah,
with that?
So... Since I was a little girl, I always used to compete in dance. I do hip-hop, contemporary, jazz, lyrical, a little bit of everything besides ballet.
Mm-hmm.
Never do that. But, so yeah,
you
used to
compete. You
look
like a ballerina, though.
Really? That's a first.
Hip-hop is one of my favorite dance styles, too. I've been taking
oh,
yeah. classes since I was 3 years old.
I love it. Like, my favorite's, like, the tutting. We do different shapes.
Mm-hmm.
So anyways, I used to compete on a team when I moved here. I used to just dance for, like, music videos, and
yeah.
then I actually got scouted to be a backup dancer for a Russian music artist. Her
Ooh.
Name's Paulina, which she actually won The Voice in Ukraine, and
Amazing.
She's done a lot, so it's been a
so
lot of fun.
So do you go on tour with her?
Yes. So actually right now, pretty much what we're doing is different dance numbers.
Uh-huh.
So, like, we have, like, a French dance, Japanese dance, so it's all these different genres,
Amazing.
And she's singing them all in different you know, languages.
Very cool.
So it's been a lot of fun.
Very cool. So where are some of the coolest places you've performed with her?
Let's see.
On The Voice?
No. No. So pretty much her, where she is located is like Ocean Parkway, Brooklyn. So every time we rehearse, we're down there. And there's this place called the Baku Palace. And since they're all Russian, that's like their hangout
mm-hmm.
place. So.
But have you traveled with her anywhere?
No, we have not traveled anywhere yet. We just perform there. I know we're talking about going on like a little tour thing.
Mm-hmm.
But right now, especially like with my career, I've been busy with that. And dance is just something more like a hobby for me.
Okay.
Yeah, so I like to keep modeling as my main.
Yeah. You know, another thing I really love about your modeling career is that you don't, even though you look really tall, because you have, like, that kind of whole slender physique
mm-hmm.
thing going on, you actually aren't the typical model height, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you tell us how tall you are?
So I'm actually 5'5" and a half.
So how inspiring is that, guys, that you can be 5'5" and a half, but I'm sure your resume says at least 5'6", right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
You know, we can let that slide.
It's okay to tweak a little bit. Not really, but okay, whatever. So what's so inspiring about that is that she's on billboards. She's modeled for Macy's. She's modeled for Marc Jacobs. She's modeled for, what are some of the other ones?
Tamari Sunglasses.
The Backpack Company.
Sprayground. Let's see. I've been on, like, the History Channel, like, acting as well.
Yeah.
There's multiple stuff in smaller brands that
yes.
could go on forever, but those
yes.
are like, you know, the large ones.
Yes.
But I have friends who are even like 5'1" and they're out there killing it. So don't ever think that height's an issue. It used to be, but honestly, runway doesn't even pay that much. So if we're being
well,
honest here.
but the good news is that I love that we're finally reaching a time where us shorter girls have opportunities to actually model and be able to showcase that talent
yeah.
or that passion that that a lot of girls have
mm-hmm.
who maybe just weren't born with a certain height. You know, I mean, I think that that was always something that kind of bothered me about the industry. It's so wonderful and inspiring to hear when, you know, someone like your height, 5'5", 5'6", is able to book these amazing, incredible high-end modeling jobs. I mean, Marc Jacobs, what kind of, tell us about that job. That's awesome.
So it's a campaign for their new fragrance, you know, Daisy. Mm-hmm. So it's a holiday campaign.
Doesn't smell good, be honest.
Yes, it was. I'll have to show you the behind the scenes photos, but we had like those huge bottles that you see that are like literally so heavy, and we're over here like acting like it's so light, and we're like struggling with our muscles. No, but it was really nice. They did it like kind of a little DJ area. It's like room 59 or something like that. There's like some type of theme, but it was really nice, and the cast was amazing, and we were all pretty much like dancing, having fun. It was like a little prom scene. So it was a lot of fun.
Nice. So is that out now? Can we see it?
No, that actually comes out in a couple months as well.
Okay, all right. So be on the lookout for that too, guys. Yep. Stay tuned. You're going to see my girl Savannah all over the place. She's taking over the New York scene.
No, but back to the height thing, like, for example, Victoria's Secret, honestly, I feel like maybe in a couple years coming up, that I feel like their standards are going to change from the 5'9", 6'.
Here's hoping.
I feel it coming. There's a lot of complaints out there. I feel it.
So what would you say has been the hardest thing for you so far, you know, pursuing
honestly,
this career?
I would have to say the height thing. You know, now it's getting way better. Like I said, it's not impossible. It's possible, but like I said, when I first moved here, I went to some of the agencies, and they're like, oh, well, we love your look for sure, but you're not height standard. Well, you're not going to be able to tell my height in the photos.
Yeah.
So why does it matter in the first place?
Yeah. I mean, so it's not like you're going for runway-only auditions.
Exactly. This is all commercial work. Like,
yeah.
I don't know. That's something, like I said, that's progressing to change. But
no, I have to, when you first sent your pictures, when you, you know, applied to whatever it was, you know, how we connected, I drew pictures stood out in me right away. Immediately, I thought you were at least 5'8".
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Well, that's good to hear.
There are certain ways to shoot, you know, I mean, that make yourself appear taller. Mm-hmm. And if you have the right body type to help, you know, facilitate that, like, you can really, like, make yourself look however tall you want in a photo.
Yeah, totally agree.
You know, even without needing to do, you know, annoying, crazy editing like people are doing now that's just, obnoxiously over the top. Like, you know, I feel bad for guys nowadays, honestly, because, you know, all the editing that's happening out there, like, on social media, like, if you meet somebody online, you don't know who's showing up.
Exactly. Like, there's apps like Makeup Plus, all that stuff that literally change your face. Like, it's insane.
Yeah.
No, but actually, I did a photo shoot one time, and they sent me the pictures. It was for, like, a hair company. And my whole face was reconstructed. I was like, why would you hire me if you're going to change my whole face? You couldn't even tell it was me. I looked like a freaking avatar. It was crazy.
Once I got booked for before and after shoots, and oh my God, I'll never do that again, because they purposely, like, made me look as ugly as possible. I thought it was just going to be, like, before, like, normal, and then after, like, you know, extra. But it was, the before was like, let me take you down a couple notches, and then we'll bring you back to normal, and then, and not show that, and then only show the final, like, fully complete design. And I was like, oh, hell no. But I had already, like, you know, accepted the job, so I didn't want to be, like, you know,
That looks great.
But when and I'm not telling you who that is or what's that for, because I hope nobody ever finds it. But yeah, that was a learning experience.
Oh my gosh, yeah. And you're like, oh, that looks awesome. Thanks. Yeah.
So do you miss, you know, home?
I mean, I definitely miss my family, you know, it's
How
a drastic
often do you get
change.
To see them?
They came here a little bit before Christmas, so that was the last time I saw them, and I'm thinking to go back maybe in April when things kind of calm down.
Yeah.
But I definitely miss it, you know, I miss my car. Oh my God, walking is the worst here.
I miss my car too. In fact, when I moved to Manhattan, I didn't move from far, but it was just, I grew up on Long Island, went to college upstate New York, and then moved to Manhattan as soon as I graduated. But I tried bringing my car with me to the city initially. I got 3 flat tires in 3 months and a hit and run. The garage across the street for me, it cost $600 a month, and that was back in 2006, so I can imagine how much a garage costs now. Yeah. But, and so after those 3 months, I was like, Oh, hell no. You're done. Because I have a BMW convertible, stick shifts. Like, it's my baby. Like, I was not going to, you know, let my car go through more than that. Like, I'm ruining the rims, like, the hit and run. Mm-hmm. It was just like, you got to be kidding me. So now I've kept it in a storage garage on Long Island all these years because I
can't. And it's still there?
Yes. Because I can't, with no plates on it or anything, I just can't, you know, take myself mm-hmm. to sell it because it's, like, it's rare to even find a stick shift BMW.
Do you think you'll try driving again in the city, or you think you're completely done, just gonna sit there for how long?
I don't know. I mean, if this show makes me super rich and famous, maybe I can have it in some, you know, very private garage situation. But no, I'm kidding. Honestly, it really doesn't make sense to drive in the city mm-hmm. at all. I actually ended up getting a bicycle. And now that is my fastest way of transportation around Manhattan.
Yeah, it's good exercise, too.
I do not like traffic. I do not like subways. And the bicycle, I get to work out at the same time. So it's a win-win situation.
Yeah, that's really nice.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
All right, so I think we're getting close to the end of the show here. So a couple things before we wrap up. Is there anything, any advice that you want to give to aspiring models in their teenage years mm-hmm. who are, you know, just starting out? What are some of the things that you would want to say to them?
I would say, like, starting out young is awesome. You're ahead of start of people who are, you know,
my
20,
age.
30. No, stop. No, so it's good to start young. And people say, oh, you need to go to college. Like, you need to have a backup plan. You know, but a lot of people are going to college now, they're going in debt, and they don't even get the job they want when they graduate college. So you gotta think what you really want. Do you wanna be doing that your whole life?
Yeah.
So just go
for it. The fact that you moved here and gave up your whole family, you know, hometown, everything, to come to New York and pursue this full throttle automatically shows your commitment just from that.
Yeah, like, you should know, like, what you want and, like, how bad you want it, mm-hmm. and then I'll see mm-hmm. what you do to get it. So just never give up, and mm-hmm. remember, like, when you fall down, just say, stand back right up and fight that wall.
Right. There might be some agencies and whatnot that may turn you down, but there are others that you're going to get booked
mm-hmm.
for.
Everything happens for
and
a reason.
And then we'll see always you on a Zumba that. Billboard, you know, just like that, right? From getting scammed $2,000 on the Zumba mm-hmm. billboard. She did not give up, guys. She is an inspiration to us all. I wish you the very best of luck.
Thank you so much.
In all of your future endeavors. I know your modeling career is going to continue to blossom inside and outside Tools for Talent, and I'm so happy to have you
part
of it.
Yes, give me a hug. Thank you so much.
Thank you for being here, sweetheart.
Yes, thank you.
All right. Again, you guys are watching Tools for Talent on TFT TV. I'm your host, Cheryl Martinez, and our special guest today was Savannah Vinson.
Bye, guys. Stay warm.
You guys enjoyed the show. Check out more from Tools for Talent all over our website, toolsfortalent.com. You can also connect with us on social media at Tools for Talent everywhere. And stay tuned for what's next.